We have our Atomos Ninja Flame here. It's a 7-inch external monitor recorder. And this here is a Tascam, whatever numbers and letters. It's an external mic. Also that big hairy monster up there with the Nikon P1000. Our Skywatcher AZ GTI go-to mount. That's how it's powered. And there we go. In the muck. There we go. Hello there. Alrighty, hello there. We're finally back. Today is the first day of March 2020 at 6:04 p.m. up here in northeastern Ohio. And way high up in the south, we have a 41 to 42% lit moon up there. Oh, let's turn that information off. Okay. Let's try to get this in there. That'll make it a little bit smaller so it fits on the screen. There we go. It's about nearly halfway lit. But it looks pretty up there in the light blue sky. It's pretty hazy up here because the muck planes have been at work, as we see that one going by there. Right below the moon. So it's been spreading across our sky all day since this morning. Anyway, I came out early to try to get a shot of the moon while it's still a little bit warm out. I think it's about 42 degrees right now. Now, I tried to get footage last night, but it was below freezing and I just could not handle it. I got a little bit of footage with the Canon EOS R. Helicopters making a lot of noise there. But yeah, like I was saying, I tried to get some footage last night, which I did, but it just wasn't worth putting a video together. Because I had the full frame camera out here and I didn't have a very long telephoto lens on, and so. But anyway, let's going a bit further. Well, we have this mega zoom camera out here because I would like to come out when Venus finally rises. But doing so with the other camera, the Canon, and try to focus here on our light beam area. It's coming in pretty well. And there we go. There's some max zoom of the Nikon P1000. And check out one of my favorite spots. It's all the craters down here in the lower portion of the moon. And who knows, we might do a crop zoom in Final Cut Pro to go in even further. But maybe not too. We'll see when we go in. But we'll just take a quick stroll around here. There we go, there's the very tip, top, the tip top of the moon. All right. So back where we started. And that cool mesa. And zoom back out. Double check our settings for the few people who want to know. So we're on the ISO 125 and the shutter speed's 1/100th, and we're at 1080p 60. But that's quite cool looking. There, try to brighten it up to more what the sky looks like, but on the monitor it's showing this very pretty blue, but to the eye it's very, very pale. There's another aircraft. Enough there. So over. So over here in the west is where Venus will eventually show up, right around where the plane is. And it might be a good 15 minutes before. Whoops. That thing just fell. You little fucker, you. Another plane. But yeah, it'll be about another, oh, good 20 minutes maybe before Venus will show. So we'll come back out in a little bit. Alrighty, there we go. We're back out. We ran the battery down on the Nikon P1000, so we're out here on the Canon 80D with the Tamron 18-400mm lens. But as it's gotten darker, we can see both the crescent moon and Venus. Now Venus is over in the west. Right above the treetop there. And the clouds. All right, we have an out of focus Venus. Okay, we're gonna get in a bit closer here. We'll go to the digital zoom part the camera has. There we go. Looks like a bright shining star. Whoa. Some muck trails going by. Oops. There we go. We have the alignment done. And we're gonna try that nifty trick of using the 6-stop ND filter. Alrighty, and there we go. Let me check the app to see more information on Venus. It is 62.3% illuminated. And it's 37 degrees above the horizon in the western sky. And again, we are on the tracking mount, so that's why it's not racing out of frame like it would if we were just on a regular video head pan head. Okay, so that fuzzy ball there is Venus, which I'll probably do a crop zoom in Final Cut Pro. Alright, so that should be the best focus we can get for it on this one. Which isn't quite as good as the P1000, not with this digital zoom part. But it's still quite cool what we can capture with just a camera nowadays. I mean, technology has just advanced so much. Anyway, that's quite cool. Now it's a shame the only thing I can see are these two. There's not even a glint of Sirius or Betelgeuse or Orion, anything. Actually, I do see Sirius through the tree branches, but okay, well, I was hoping to get a look at the Orion Nebula and constellation and all that, but we can at least see the belt there. All right, anyway, that's going to do it. I'll get a few pictures and probably throw them in here if they come out. Anyway, y'all take care. I hope you have a wonderful new week ahead. Be safe and stay warm and keep out of the puddles. It's 6:50 p.m. up here. Alrighty. Good night now.